What is up, guys? Razor here. Welcome back to White Knight Chronicles 1 Remastered for the PS3. Last time, completed Nordia Tunnels and got an S in Brave Litten's Plight. And in this episode, it's time to go to the Lagnish Desert. This area is massive. Probably one of the biggest areas in the game as well. It's gonna take a. Gonna be here a while. Probably for a few episodes, I'd imagine.
To it, Yuli.
Urbana is not as far as you might think, but there are monsters in these sands. We'll have to keep our strength up for the battles ahead.
Yeah, we know. Hey, you think I could learn how to dance?
No, I don't.
I never featured you a man of color.
But yeah, as you can tell, there's where we gotta go right there, is Urbana. But this desert is, like, huge. If I'm not mistaken, the south path is blocked by something, I think. So I kind of want to go down the south path first. Of this path over here. Might be a chest over here, so I'll go this way first.
Anybody know which way we're headed?
Yeah, the bees are weak to thrust. That's a new Vespid too, by the way, Killer Vespid.
Things are looking up.
We're gonna have to use the White Knight against the Fire Giant. Weak to thrust. Yep. I'm just gonna keep spamming thrust. These things will take a long time to take down if you don't use the White Knight, though. One more hit. Nice. Got a Chromium Pearl and a Chromium Pearl level 2. Sometimes you can harvest those cactus. Yeah, right here you can. You slash against the bears or the boars. Yeah, I'm going to go down the south path here. I think it's a dead end, if I'm not mistaken. But I still want to go down this path to see if there's any treasure or anything like that. So that's where I'm going to go. There's a new enemy there, a scorpion enemy. If I could take this Vespid out first. Scorpion! There's a chest over there on the other side. I hope we got another new enemy up ahead. Scorpions are weak to lunge. Grab this chest over here. Targe. Which is probably an upgrade of what I got, I'd imagine. Yes, it is. Okay, 6 points for the main, or for the creator character. Oh, and by the way, I got a Leonard Swordmaster 3, by the way. In the last episode when I was doing the Brave Litten's Plight. Okay, learn healing, or I can learn Healing Breeze, Fatigue, and Mollify. Oh, so that's like Regen from the Final Fantasy games. Fatigue lowers one opponent's attack. That's pretty good. Mollify lower one opponent's defense. Okay, Megalo Tigris. Weak to slash. I don't have the White Knight ready, so I'm gonna have to fight it straight up here. Thank you. There we go. Knocked it down. Ooh, nice damage there. Come on, almost got it. Hurry up. Nice. See, it's not so hard. Even without the knight, it's not that bad. Yeah, so see? You can't go this way. At least I got that chest over there and we fought that enemy. The enemy gave a decent amount of EXP. A lot of gold, too. And I got some items there. Levin Stone Shard, Wind Beast Mane, and Bristly Pelt. That'll be used for crafting later on. It also built up my transform for the next big enemy. Anything over here? Doesn't look like it. I don't know where any of the chests are in this desert, so I'm going to have to just explore as much as I can, because I don't know where any of the chests are.
Let's do this.
It seems like it's wide open, but it's actually pretty linear. So it shouldn't be that bad to find the chest.
Anybody know which way we're headed?
No, we got a fire elemental here, which we fought in the Nordia tunnels. Now they're weak to water, which I don't have access to. Well, I do, but. I don't really want to use that right now. Let's go north here, and then I'll make a way up that way. Another one of those Tigris things. Yeah, the thing's like a Cerberus, kind of. Reminds me of a Cerberus, anyway. What? They do no damage. Why is it doing zero? Alright, that's it for the White Knight. Okay. I want to go back this way.
As long as we keep our bearings, we'll be fine.
It's like we can harvest over here. Fossilized rock. Oh, a chest over here. Up another giant. Got to fight it straight up. No White Knight. Oh, they're weak to thrust, I think. Yep. I'll get rid of the fire elemental first. Nice. Guardian Pearl level 1. Got a broadsword. Probably weaker than the machete though, right? Yeah. Alright, another leveled up there. So let's see, Moon Slash. Yeah, you got the different stances. I don't really care about this. I think I might get one of those abilities up here. A Raging Blade seems good. And then as for Yulei, Divine Magic. We'll grab Fatigue. And also grab Healing Breeze as well. I want her to focus on healing again. She still attacks even when she's focusing on healing, so that's good. Yeah, around here you can actually fall off the edge. So you gotta be careful not to fall off. Or else you have to go all the way back around if you do. Crazy boar, charge me again. Okay, so if we go down here, we're not going to be able to go back up. We're going to have to go all the way around. But you got to do it anyway, because you got to get the chest. Desert tunic. Nice resistance by 2, and it also boosts defense by 5, pretty good. Alright, so now we gotta go back up where we were at before. I had to grab that chest. Just gonna avoid the enemy since we already fought them. Alright, now we can make our way east. And then eventually north. We have all that to explore. I wouldn't mind getting Obana in this episode though. Need to go up there.
We'll be out of this sandbox in no time.
All right. Keep clinging to that.
At least you've got spirit.
Just getting started.
Anybody know which way we're headed?
Alright, chest down over here. I'll probably grab this chest and then we'll head on into Albana. Because that'll be the that'll be it for this episode. I'm going to use thrust on this thing. Alright. Trying to make the white nut angry. Chromium Pearl level 2. Alright. So obviously I'll explore more of the desert in the next episode. But I want to go down to the Albana. And we'll explore the rest of it. Yeah, like I said, in the next episode. Actually, the next episode will probably be Albana, and then the following episode will be more desert, more than likely. We'll see how it goes, though. Here we are.
Water.
Look, there.
Albana. Why, the welcomes are as hostile as the desert.
If I fall over, one of you pick me up, okay?
Alright, here we are in Agrabah. I'm kidding. Desert town of Albana. Pretty much Agrabah.
Wow, this place is hopping.
So, what now?
Guess Tatooine as well.
Find out if anyone's seen any black mono ships.
Right.
It's so lively.
We'll never find a more wretched hive of scum and villainy. In Albana. So there's a ton of people you can talk to. We're just going to talk to the people we can recruit. Because, yeah, there'll be errands we can pick up here later or whatever with some of these people. Memorial Servant. Give him the shaft. Lahamu and Lamu. Lamu. Okay. We literally have one Dahila, by the way. We only got one Dahila for completing that quest earlier.
I can't believe this is a desert town.
Yeah, make sure to pick up that quest, because we're going to be doing that probably in the next episode. Okay, Timothy, we can recruit.
Throat's dry and my eyes hurt. I don't think I like this town.
I guess this place is also kind of like Rosa, if you played Rogue Galaxy. Yeah, I would talk to everybody around here, guys, but there's just so many people to talk to. I just don't find it worth it. They put way too many NPCs in this game. Oh, my stomach's like growling. I'm not even hungry.
How could they miss it?
It's far too big to hide, that's for sure.
Okay, Mana Potion 2. It's like we don't have any errands in this area yet. There will be errands here later, though. And you'll bet we'll do them too. Okay, here we have the general store. You can buy shards here if you need to. I don't know why you'd want to, but you can.
The fastest way to get information.
Then let's try the shops.
Maybe we should visit the square.
But this is the jeweler. Yep, Desert Keep. Got a lot of stuff already. Magical earrings. Fighter's earrings, plus 3 to strength. Wow. Buy one of those for Leonard. Iron earrings. Yeah, notice how these ones have like a downside as well. It's not just like they boost your stats by a lot, but there's also a downside to it as well. The downside's not really that bad though. Boost defense by 1. Some nice strength bonus there. Put all this stuff in storage. Leonard's inventory gets full pretty quick. See, I want to give him the vitality boosting one. There we go. It does drop his resistance a little bit, but yeah, maybe it's not worth it. I don't think it is worth it, actually. I don't want to lower his magic defense. Anyway, the main character leveled up recently, I didn't know. Or the creative character. Ooh, Judgment and MP plus. Oh, that's cool. Kind of like an AoE arrow attack.
Hey, mind if we rest?
Pretty generic ability though, to be honest, because it's in a lot of games. Wow, Giorama level 10. That's insane. Okay, battle knife. I can give that to her. Claymore, don't have one of those. Warrior's Axe. Hunting bow. I think I already have a bone rod, yeah. Desert tunic I have. Okay, the desert stuff's for, it's for her. Medium's for my main, my creative guy. And then heavy stuff's for Leonard. Bold shield. Put this copper stuff in storage. Targ in storage. Traveler stuff in storage. Dagger in storage. Genie ring in storage. Alright, there we go. Got our equipment all set up. Honestly, with a bow character, you could probably get away with light armor, I think. I don't know if the bow is considered light or heavy, moderate. Let's find out. Oh, it's light, so I should give him light equipment instead. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. I think it's just better. I know I pretty much wasted the money on that, but it's alright. There we go. Now he's light. Light, and then Leonard's a tank, he's the heavy. Alright guys, I'm going to go back to the save point, and that'll be it for this episode. So thank you guys for watching, stay tuned for the next episode, and later.
I can't believe this is a desert town.